Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss the questions from the subject design of steel structures which appeared in MES 2018. Question number 1. The inclination of a lacing bar with the axis of the compression member is theta, then theta shall not be less than, and the four options are given. Now in order to get the correct option for this question, we will have to refer to IS code IS 800 clause 7.6.4. Now it states that lacing bars, whether in double or single systems, shall be inclined at an angle not less than 40 degrees nor more than 70 degrees to the axis of built up member. It means that the minimum angle is 40 degrees. Option 2 is the correct option. Next question. A column splice is used to increase. Now you all know that column splice is used to increase the length of the column. Sometimes in order to get the desired length of the column, two or more members are connected to one another to get the desired length of column, and this connection is called as splicing. So option 1 is the correct option. Next question. In a cantilever plate girder, to prevent web buckling, horizontal stiffeners are provided running along the span. They are provided, and the four options are given. Now, in order to go for the correct option, we should understand buckling first. Now, buckling happens because of compressive load. And as such, in case of plate girders, the web may suffer buckling. And that part of the wave which lies in the compression zone may suffer buckling. And we know that in case of cantilever beam or plate girder, the compression exists below the neutral axis. And as such, the portion of the wave which is lying below the neutral axis may suffer buckling. And in order to prevent the wave buckling, horizontal stiffeners are required to be provided below the neutral axis, that is in compression zone of the wave. So correct option is option 1, below the neutral axis. Next question. Number of bolts required in a bolted joint is equal to force divided by, and the four options are given. Now in order to get the correct option here, we should understand the strength of the bolt first. Now strength of the bolt is also called as bolt value. And bolt value is lesser of shearing or bearing strength of the bolt. A bolt may fail due to shearing or it may fail due to bearing. The lesser of the strength of the bolt in these two, that is shearing strength and bearing strength, is called as bolt value. And number of bolts can be obtained by taking the ratio of force to the bolt value. So force divided by bolt value is equal to number of bolts. So the correct option is option number 1. Next question. The deflection of beams may be decreased by. Four options are given. First, increasing the depth of the beam. Second, increasing the span. Third, decreasing the depth of the beam, increasing the width of the beam. Now in order to explain this question, I have considered two cases. Let it be a case of simply supported beam of span L and a central point load W is acting. And it is a case in which UDL of W per unit run is running over the entire span of length L. Now here, the maximum deflection is given by WL cube upon 48 EI. Here, the maximum deflection is given by 5 by 384 WL raised to 4 upon EI. Now, if we observe these two formulae, we can see that maximum deflection here is directly proportional to cube of the span, whereas here it is directly proportional to fourth power of the span. So delta max is either proportional to L cube or proportional to L raised to 4. So here, if we increase the span, if the span is increased, it will result in increase in the deflection of the beam. It will not be decreased. So increasing the span, the deflection will increase. So this option is wrong. Let us go for the depth. Now, in both of these formulae, we can see that delta max is inversely proportional to moment of inertia. So, delta max is inversely proportional to moment of inertia. Now, as delta max is inversely proportional to moment of inertia, If we increase the moment of inertia, then delta max will be decreasing. And in order to increase the moment of inertia, we should increase the depth of the beam. And that is why increasing the depth of the beam will result in increase in moment of inertia. And as moment of inertia increases, the maximum deflection will decrease. And that is why the correct option for this question is option number one. Next question. The Indian standard code which deals with steel structures is. Now the correct option is option number 3, IS 800. IS 800 is the general code of practice for construction in steel. So option 3 is the correct option. Next question. The slenderness ratio of lacing bars shall not exceed. Now the four values are given. Now in order to have the correct answer for this question, we will have to refer to IS 800 clause 7.6.6.3, which states that the slenderness ratio KL by R of the lacing bars shall not exceed 145, and that is why the correct option is option number 3. Next question. The effective length of fillet weld is taken as. The four options are given. Again, to have the correct answer, we will have to refer to clause 10.5.4 in IS 800. Now, which recommends that effective length of fillet weld shall be taken as only that length which is of the specified size and required throat thickness. In practice, the actual length of weld is made of the effective length shown in the drawing plus 2 times the weld size, but not less than 4 times the size of weld. So remember it well. In practice, the actual length is equal to effective length plus 2 times the size of the weld. So here the effective length can be obtained as, the relation is like this: actual length is equal to effective length plus 2 times the size of the weld, if S is the size of the weld. And that is why effective length will be equal to actual length minus 2 times the size of the weld. And that is the correct option is option number 2. Next question. The fusible material used in welding to dissolve and facilitate the removal of oxides and other undesirable substances is known as. Now the correct option is option number 3, which is flux. Option 3 is the correct option. Next question. Which of the following equations is correct for both subjected to combined shear and tension? And they have mentioned four terms. V is the applied shear at service load. VSDF is equal to design shear strength. TE is equal to externally applied tension at service load. TNDF is equal to design tension strength. Now to have the correct option, we should refer IS 800 again. The clause 11.6.2.5. So clause number 11.6.2.5. Now as per this clause, the ratio of the shear at service load to the design shear strength and square of this plus the ratio of externally applied tension to the design tensile strength and square of this should be less than or equal to 1. So option 1 is the correct option. Next question. What is the yield strength of bolt of class 4.6? The four options are given. Now here, to mark the correct option, we should know what is the class of a bolt. Now bolts are classified into different classes depending upon their strength. If a bolt has a class A point B, it has a specific meaning. Now in such cases, we can get the yield stress of bolt as well as the ultimate stress of bolt. So yield stress can be obtained as A into B into 10. Means if these are the two numbers, so get the product of these two, A into B, multiply it by 10, you get the yield strength of bolts. Whereas ultimate strength of bolts from the given class can be obtained as A into 100. So for an example, if the class is given as 4.6, it means that its yield strength is equal to A over here is 4, B is 6 into 10, so which is equal to 240 newtons per mm square. Similarly, ultimate strength of bolt can be obtained as A into 100. So A over here, if we compare these two, A is equal to 4. So 4 into 100 is 400. But here the question is related to yield strength, and yield strength is 240. Option 2 is the correct option.